Hey, welcome back to Power Wash SpongeBob. They actually got a couple boats here. Luckily, I only have to clean the, I already don't remember what the hell this was called. It's the something. It is the same day I've done some other recording, and I am incredibly fucking tired. I'm doing that thing where you try to go from a bad sleep schedule to a good sleep schedule by just staying awake for like 15 hours longer than you rightfully ought to, but you know that it's gonna work. It absolutely has to, because I don't really have another solution. I need to get my sleep schedule back to fucking normal, because it's getting back to school. School's about to start up again. And for me, I've got to actually be able to go at a normal fucking time of the day instead of waking up at 10 p.m. and going to sleep at fucking 10 a.m. That makes it sound a lot like I sleep for 12 hours, and that does happen. But what really happened to me recently, and actually very often, instead of sleeping for 12 hours, I require like 12 hours of sleep or more to feel rested, but I never actually get that much fucking rest. I end up sleeping for like 4 hours, and then I wake up to some alarm or something like that. It's not great. It doesn't feel good. I'm in a constant state of I'm absolutely fucking tired and really want to go back to sleep, but I hate sleep. I don't want to sleep. I'm already more than halfway done. It is weird again that they want me to clean the interior of a fucking car. That doesn't really make sense. It also doesn't really make sense that the inside and the outside of the windshield are the same fucking thing, but it's just as fitting as what I was talking about last time. It's fine. It feels kind of weird, but this is sort of the evolved version of that Jeep from the Tomb Raider one. I wasn't a fan of that, since I wasn't expecting to be able to open the doors, since the game hadn't really primed me to be allowed to open the doors on a vehicle before. I wasn't thinking that that was something that I would be allowed to do. So it was weird to be able to get into the Jeep and open the doors so that I could actually get a good angle and everything on all the spots I needed to hit. For this one, no doors, just straight up General Lee style here. You got to jump through the, well, no windows, so I'll call it General Lee style, even though that is clearly an abomination of a statement. There's the bun, and that should be the whole damn seat. Nope. I'm missing a bunch of little angles and shit off to the side. This is what keeps happening to me. I'm missing all the, like, little spots and shit. So there's the spatula in the seat. And then clearly I'm missing something. Oh, no. I wasn't missing something there. Steering wheel? What am I missing on the steering wheel? Fucking underneath the steering wheel? There we go. All right. I don't know what all is left, but I know that the flag pole and the flag are. So I'll get those out of the way before I check my list. This time I did a pretty fucking good job of sticking to my plan. I made a decision of exactly where I needed to go and what needed to get cleaned, and it actually fucking worked. And also did a pretty good job of seeing there's no chance that I fucking cleaned off the propeller. So that's done now. And the patty still needs to be cleaned. But I've actually got a list of things. Oh, a longer list of things. Engine. See, this is the same shit. God damn it. There's an openable hatch for the engine. And I'm guessing this is a front engine car. Since most of them are. Yep, there's the fucking... There's the hood. Well, a lot of this stuff is just cleaning itself pretty fucking quick. Then the lid is really fucking dirty. But... I can get that done. You know, I was just kind of sort of praising myself for having this time been so, like, tired. My brain was not in a position to go off on, like, a tangent or anything. I was just fucking about to say that I was cleaning everything in a proper order, and it was getting done well, and then I saw, oh, there's an engine compartment. I need to fucking clean the engine parts, and completely ignored the fact there were still things outside of the engine compartment that I had not cleaned yet. Wait, really? No. There was something else. I could swear there was. Oh, is it just the hood? I cleaned half of the hood. Okay. Well, you know what? I'm going to count that as a win because I accidentally did it right. And this kind of went in some spirals, but the footage is not as fast as I would have liked it to be. That's the paddy wagon, all right. Did Sandy tell you that she cracked the case? We're calling in Mermaid Man and Barnacle Boy. They're the only ones who can stop the grubby fiend. All right. So the next thing is the invisible boatmobile. That shouldn't take me all that long either. So this is a short episode, I'm sure, and so will the next one be, more than likely. Oh, but that's invisible. How the fuck do I clean an invisible thing? Like, I can see all the grime on it. It's going to get difficult fast, I bet. Well, I hope you enjoyed this one. I hope you come back for the next one. We'll see how crazy that shit is. I'll see y'all later. Bye.